Burner flame shape ideal for cement kiln operation. The shape of the flame of the main burner kiln greatly affects the quality, production capacity of the clinker and the operation of the kiln as a whole. The shape of a good burner flame will produce high temperatures and can react raw meal into clinker more easily with good quality. On this occasion, we will explain about the ideal form of burner flame in the operation of a kiln in a cement factory. The ideal burner flame shape for kiln operation in a cement plant is short, strong, hot, and stable. A short flame shape can be achieved by increasing the air pressure of the primary fan above 240 bar and the primary air volume between 6% and 8% of the required total combustion air. Flames with high temperatures can be achieved if the quality of pulverized coal is less than 8% moisture content, residue 90 microns is less than 12%, and does not fluctuate. Then the secondary air temperature is more than 850 degrees Celsius. Parameters of the fuel combustion process in the kiln can be seen on the combustion indicator at the kiln inlet. For example, CO is below 0.3%, O2 is between 1.0 and 1.4%, and temperatures are between 1000 and 1100 degrees Celsius. The target direction of the kiln burner flame. The ideal direction of the burner flame position is the flame does not touch the material or touch the brick wall in the kiln continuously. The ideal flame is at the midpoint of the kiln diameter, as shown in this image. The temperature is related to visual observation of the color of fire in the field. It can be seen in this table that the color of the fire is blackish red with the lowest temperature or less than 500 degrees Celsius. Then, the color of the white fire became a brilliant white with a temperature of more than 1540 degrees Celsius. The ideal burner flame color for kiln operation is light yellow to white. Previously, we explained about setting the shape of the flame, which is related to high air pressure and low air volume in order to get a short and strong flame shape. The question is, how to do it? The first is to set the axial air damper opening to 100% and the radial air damper opening to 40 to 45%. Or adjust the volume of axial air and radial air through a manual damper in the field, measured manually on the primary fan air duct in the field. Axial air is set 65 to 70%. And radial air is 30 to 35% of the total air volume from primary air fan. The second is, it can reduce the burner tip gap to be narrower in order to get high air pressure and low air volume from the primary fan. Of the several types of burners we have operated, it is recommended to use primary fan air between 6% to 8%. Of the total required combustion air. How to calculate total combustion air required? We take the example of the combustion process that uses pulverized coal. The calculation formula is as follows: equals 8.89 C plus 26.67 H minus 3.330 plus 3.33 S. As an example, C or carbon, 76%, H or hydrogen, 5%, O or oxygen, 12%, S or sulfur, 1%. So, the result of the calculation is, equals 7.7236 normal meter cubic per kilogram of coal. If the use of fine coal in the main burner equals 20 tons per hour, then the air required for the fuel combustion process is 154,472 normal meter cubic per hour. It means, for primary air usage, between 6% to 8% should be used 9,269 to 12,359 normal meter cubic per hour. That was the explanation about setting the ideal flame shape and calculating the use of primary fan air, which is used in the fuel combustion process in the kiln main burner in the cement production process. Thank you for watching this video. hopefully it's useful, and don't forget to subscribe, like and comment, and share it with your friends who need it. See you in the next video.